with the LMAI president, Mr. Kuldeep Goyal, who also runs his own printing company and graphics from Noida. Hello, sir, and thank you for your time.
Hi, Priti.
Sir, today we are going to have a discussion on the current pandemic in India as well as worldwide. So my first question to you is that with the lockdown in India now extended to May 3, how is the labor industry, Indian labor industry, braving the impact?
Number one, we have to think about two aspects. First one is short term and second is long term. It is not just related to labor industry, of course, it is with everyone in industry. Short-term concerns are how to face liquidity problem, keep intact bonding with our current customers, feeding to essential items so that they can maintain their supply chain, and plan about how to open the factory. So in this aspect, the main issue is number one, to keep maintain our liquidity, because everybody knows that after that we are going to open our units, we have to face this issue very severely. I'll address it, I will explain it later on. And second is to keep intact bonding with our manpower too, because you will find a lot of people, a lot of manpower has been migrated, they are migrated already. And if I open the factory, if I open my unit, if they are of immediate need to run my factory, so I have to make a plan that how to get them back. And if I'm unable to find them back, how to run my factory? Because it will be required immediate. Third one, to keep bonding with our current customers. Because after this lockdown is open, the customers may be worried about your, say, concerns about that, how you tackle with corona in your factory, how you sanitize that. So we have to keep them informed that we are ready with this. So it is again comes under short-term planning, how to just make our factory ready to run immediately after the lockdown period is over. So we have to address this say challenge immediately. We have to start thinking about this. So everybody, every label printer is working in the same way. Every label supplier is working in the same way. And one more aspect in short term, that essential industries depend upon label printers and of course the complete packaging industry. So many of us are supposed to run their factory, maybe with 5% capacity, maybe with 50% of capacity. This is not a matter of say profit, how much we are creating. It's a matter of our social obligation, our concern to this industry. So many of label printers are running their factory with their capacity utilization of 5%, some are with 10%, some 50%. So almost every unit member, every LME member working in this aspect, working in the same way. The second concern comes, that is a long-term. Long-term planning maybe, because in future we are sure that it will not be easy, as easy we were just doing our work before. We have to work with minimum manpower. We have to supply so many SKUs. The type of demand may change. The volume of demand may change. The quantum of demand may change. So we have to work long-term planning, for long-term planning in this aspect. So we have to go towards automation. We have to plan to work with remotely people arranged. So in that case, if we are ready with our softwares, if we are ready with our IT platform, then we can work with that. And we can utilize our this time with online training to our staff, online training to our members. So all the many of us are utilizing, planning this way. So this period may be used as blessings in disguise. So our team, our members, all are working different, say with a different problem they are facing, doing it differently. People are facing like this.
LMAI has also taken a few steps to help its printer and supplier members from the association members. So could you please elaborate on the same?
Yes. Again, LMAI thought about this, that what is the immediate concern to address with. So first, immediate concern was liquidity problems with all of our members. So we just mailed our few letters to concerned government departments, like we sent our mail to addressing our Honorable Prime Minister, our Finance Minister, and our other governing body, requesting them about that our concern of wages and salary, which are supposed to pay 100%. So we are requesting them that the wages and salary of the ESI registered people, ESI registered manpower, should be paid from ESI account. Because this lockdown period came out because of this is a medical emergency. And everybody, every entrepreneur paid their share and of course the manpower too in ESI because of medical emergencies, medical ground. So we're requesting government that it should be paid from ESI surplus account, reserve account, so that this burden should not come on our say members. Secondly, we are requesting them, instead of just moratorium on the say moratorium period for paying the installment against loan, against term loan, we are requesting them to waive off interest also. We are requesting them to waive off lease rent. We are requesting them to reduce electricity bill. So we made several requests and we already sent few mails to relevant authorities. Number one step. Secondly, to make our voice higher, we formed one federation. We almost have 14 federation members. These are associations and different federations which came under one tag. So our member strength, our strength in that case is approximately 2.5 lakh. This is generating revenue of approximately 750,000 crores. So already we sent mail to relevant authorities. We made, I think you will be getting our press release very, say maybe by tomorrow, that we have all we have sent to that government body. So to make our say voice more bigger, more, so that already we taken that.
Right, that's brilliant, sir. That's a great step to kind of come together and unite at this time. However, you also mentioned these are the steps that LMAI has taken for small and medium enterprises as well as for printers and suppliers at large. However, currently there are printers in the country who are facing the problem with the raw material supply. And with the lockdown extended to May 3, there is a possibility of, you know, the shortage of raw material. Do you see that impacting label printing business and thus the market?
Yes, it is true. In some areas, rules are very tight. Lockdown is very, very strict. But in some areas, it is liberty we are getting a little bit. So whoever is able to run their unit to feed this essential market, they are doing it. And whoever are unable to do it, they're getting help from other printer members. Suppose I don't have the dye. If my friend in nearby area is having the dye, it is possible to borrow the dye from him. And even customers are very liberal at this time. They're not asking 100% matching of their colors. They're not asking 100% accurate dyes. They're compromising with print shapes. They are compromising with dimensions of dyes, and they are not concerned about specific shade. They are compromising with the label printers. So somehow we are able to manage the situation.
How will this pandemic change consumer consumption and market trends?
Right now, if you ask about this current scenario, so demands are very limited. These are limited to essential service, essential requirements. What we need, we are buying that only. It is not just because of supply chain, it is because of people are spending less as possible. This is the mindset, because everybody is living in a little bit of fear, and so they are spending as low as possible. If you ask about after this period of crisis, it is going to change. As per my perception, I would like to say, after, suppose this corona is over, it will take another 2 months to come out of fear. 2 or 3 months, it may be 3 months also. That's some gap between the normal life and the fear life. In fear life, we are not going to spend much. We'll be buying as per our necessity, and maybe we can increase a little bit. We may go immediately after the necessity. But after this fear period is over, we'll come to our routine. But in that case, it is must that there will not be not even a single corona patient in India. Because if it is even a single case in India, we will be living in fear period. So after this fear period is over, we will be coming to our normal routine.
Right.
So demand may change a little bit. It may be a type of SKUs. It may be a different type of requirement. It may be a different type of product scenario. It may change. Our needs may be changed.
Right. Coming back to the operations, the current pandemic has also resulted in evolving workspace and the culture where a lot of people are working from home or are being forced to work from home. So do you foresee major change in work culture post-COVID-19 also, especially in manufacturing? Do you see people tending to get more automation done and at their factories or at the shop floor, so there is skeletal staff on the premise?
Yes, it is going to change a lot. And it will happen for sure. As far as manufacturing industry is concerned, more automation will be there. It will be possible to produce more material with less manpower. Control may be remotely available. The sales and marketing team may work remotely. Accounts team may come, say, alternate days. So I assume at least 10 to 15% of our manpower or man's strength would be able to work from remote areas, maybe work from. This change has to come, and this will come for sure.
Right. As soon as stay-at-home orders are lifted, sir, how soon do you imagine will the industry at large be able to resume daily operations?
It is going to take some time, depend upon how liberal government would be. Are they going to open it 100%? Are they going to open it phase-wise? Suppose they open to start with just 25% of our capacity.
Yeah.
So, to reach to 25% of our capacity, it may take 10 to 15 days. We have to set our machines to come in complete production. We have to plan our manpower to work with their 25% of capacity. Because you will find in small, especially with the small and medium type of business, they have one person of many work to do. If he is being asked to work with 25% of capacity, he has to think to whom he should bring to factory, to whom he should leave at home. So it may take at least 15 to 20 days, or maybe 1 month time to come in that situation. He should be able to work with 15 to 30% or maybe 40% capacity. After this lockdown period is completely over and there's no case of corona, I think after it may take 1 month time to resume it completely. Again, one question arises. How to deal with migrant labor? It will be very difficult to get them back to their work. Because they are worried. They are fear now. They will not be comfortable to come back to this area. So we have to get trained our new men. We have to train our manpower to work as all-rounder. It will be again next challenge. We should be ready with that. That it will be almost impossible immediately to get that migrant manpower to bring them on. But yes, we should start thinking right now. And we should try to get them that where they are and how they are. So that as soon as you start work, you can plan accordingly. So this will be a little bit of concern, but how to get that migrant manpower or replacement of them.
Right. And so lastly, I wanted to ask you, is there any message that you would like to give to fellow printers and suppliers during this pandemic on how they can, you know, keep strong during this time?
As an owner of any graphics, I'm a positive thinker. I'm emotionally attached and passionate about my business. So this is my message, that we should keep ourselves very positive. We should not decide right now anything negative. We should wait until the lockdown period is over. Then we take some more time to decide about our decision. We should be positive. If we faced very negative scenario before, we should be able to face this crisis. Government is with us. Our customers are with us. And time will come in a very good way, in a very different way. We should be keeping our finger crossed, and time will come in a very great way, I'm sure.
Thank you so much for your time, sir.